Hey DIYers, Joe here with Alarm Grid, and today we're going to talk about why your 5800 sensor may lose supervision. First, let's discuss what supervision is on 5800 devices. If you take a look, we have a 5800 mini right here. I'm going to open it up, take it out of the box. As you can see, it's a small form size sensor. Here's the magnet, here's the sensor. This sensor, just like every other 5800 device, has supervision that works with the main alarm system. There's two things that occur with supervision. The first thing that occurs is that the panel itself has a 12-hour timer that is going to check for each sensor that's programmed to it to see if a signal has come in yet. The sensors themselves have a 50 or a 70 to 90 minute timer that every time that triggers, they're going to send a signal to the panel to let it know that it's still communicating. If the panel doesn't receive one of those signals within that 12-hour period, it's going to show a supervision trouble on the system itself. The reason that it allows 12 hours for the sensor to actually communicate back with it is that there might be interference, there may be something else that happened. Just because it didn't get the first transmission doesn't necessarily mean that the sensor isn't working. Keep in mind that the 5800 sensors, they only transmit one way, except for a very select few devices. The 5800 mini is one of those devices that only transmits one way. So the panel doesn't have a way of communicating with the sensor from the panel to the sensor to see if it's awake. With the 5800 devices, that's what the 12-hour timer's for. If no signal can get to the system within that 12-hour period, it's pretty safe to say that the sensor is not successfully signaling with the system. Some reasons of why this may occur is appliances, big refrigerators, anything that has a lot of metal, mirrors, that can interrupt sensor transmission. So if you're finding that this happened and you just had some new furniture brought in or some new other stuff brought in, it's a good idea to take a look at what's in line with the sensor. Another common thing that can happen with the sensors is over time, their antenna can wear out and they can start to get more and more supervision troubles. If you do find a zone that has a sensor that has been giving you a supervision error and it's becoming more and more frequent as time goes on, it's probably recommended to replace the sensor itself and just not worry about the issue anymore. Those are the two biggest reasons that sensor supervision can occur. If you do have a sensor on the system and it is monitored, feel free to give your alarm company a call. They'll be able to pull up all of your previous data from the system and see what's going on with the sensor itself. Thanks for visiting today. If you did like the video, please subscribe. Also, if you hit the notification button below, you'll be updated whenever we post something new. If you have any questions, head over to alarmgrid.com, and we hope to see you soon. Take care.